It's not just the way we act and react to each other. It's not just these hormonal differences. I've always heard communication is the key to a good relationship, but men and women communicate differently. They've done a lot of studies that prove that women have a more verbal approach to life than we men do. And a big part of the reason is our brains are wired differently. And everybody's brain, between the right side of the brain, which is emotional side, and left side is the logical side, there's this connecting bridge called the corpus callosum, which allows thoughts to go back between two sides of the brain. Now, apparently, women have a four-lane highway there, and we guys have a little dirt path. Tends to make us guys more task-oriented, makes women more verbal. But the result is, in any day, a woman will use 25 to 30,000 words, a guy use 20 to 25,000 words. So that's what's happening. In any day, a woman just has a bigger pile of words to work from than a man does. So beginning of the day, when a man and woman go up their separate ways to do what they do during the day, the guy uses up all his words. At the end of the day, woman's got words left over. So that's what's happening when a man and woman get back together again that evening, and she's like, let me tell you what happened to me today. I came home from work, I picked up the kids from school, I took them to the library. They have a whole new CD-ROM interactive computer, kids were playing with that. I was talking to Jean Smith, the librarian. You know, Jean, that's not important. Anyway, Jean told me she has a friend visiting from her hometown. Now, this was her best friend when she was growing up. I just found out today that I went to college with her best friend from her hometown, and we did not know that we knew the same woman all the years we've known each other. We're all going to get together next week for lunch, it'll be a lot of fun. Then on the way home, I stopped, I picked up a new microwave, I put it right next to the stove, and thought it fit there perfectly in that little spot. I don't understand how you could see what fit in that little spot with actually having a microwave there to put it in there. I don't understand how your mind works like that. It's really amazing. What happened to you today? Work. Home. Beer. Sex. Remote. Happy. And I could see why my wife would want to communicate with me on this intense verbal level, because that's how my wife and her friends are. I watch my wife and her women friends. They talk on almost a daily basis about the intimate details of each other's lives, and that's how these women keep their friendships woven together, these conversations. It's just generally not that way for men. Once two guys bond as friends, they might not feel the need to talk to each other all the time unless there's some big information to be given or received. Larry, your hat's on fire. Thank you, Frank. Now, Frank won't call Larry later to find out how his hat is. He won't offer to help him shop for a new one. Fire's out, conversation's over. I'm saying this so that some women who maybe didn't understand this before will understand now that we guys have some physical limitations about how verbal we can become. I know sometimes women get real excited about the possibilities. You know, if I get my man, if I can get him talking to me every day about everything that's happening in his life, his feelings, his dreams, his hopes, it'll be great. It'll be like having my best girlfriend with a penis. We just tend to bond differently. It's okay. Not better or not worse, just different. Women tend to bond verbally. Guys tend to bond physically. I'd see my wife and her friends go out shopping on a Saturday afternoon. These women shopped all day long, came home, none of them bought anything. Yet they all still had a great time. I think all they really want to do is just go out, hang out with each other, keep up with each other's lives. And shopping was just a good excuse to get together. They bought something fine, if not, no big deal. When men get together, we generally have to find some sort of physical activity which allows us to channel our competitive instincts with each other. Go fishing. Who caught the most fish? Play a game. Basketball, golf, poker. Who won the game? Men can't shop together. We're too competitive. It'd be a financial disaster. Guys would come home completely frustrated. What's the matter? Didn't you have a good time shopping with Ed and Larry? Ed bought a fishing pole. Larry bought a boat so I had to buy the marina. Well, go ahead and laugh, but you got to quit your job and run the bait shop now. So you'd be a lawyer in a bait shop. What's wrong with that? And we tend to look to bond these ways with the opposite sex. Women look to do a lot of emotional bonding with a man through words. Guys look to do a lot of physical bonding with the women. And that's like words of endearment so important in a relationship with a woman. I mean, I can say I love you many times during the day and not bore my wife. She loves to hear it over and over. And I have to work at saying it over and over. I've learned how to do this. It's something, a skill I've had to acquire. It's not natural. See, guys tend to be task-oriented. When a man says I love you, he's saying I love you until further notice. The guy's thinking, I said I love you last Thanksgiving. It's still good today. But we work at it because we know it's real important. Part of the bonding with a woman. We work at it. We learn to do it. See, guys look to do a lot of physical bonding with a woman. When a guy's looking to make love to his woman, a lot of times he's looking for emotional bonding with her. I'm not saying women should have sex with a guy whenever he wants to, ignore your own feelings about it. I'm just saying if you don't want to have sex with a guy at the moment he's approaching you, tell him why. Even if it's some sort of problem between the two of you, explain it to him so there's no confusion. Because see, if I'm trying to make love to my wife and she just goes, I don't want to have sex. My subconscious is going, oh, she doesn't love me anymore. What happened? When did this happen? But she just takes a second to explain it to me. No, I don't have sex. I feel kind of sick. Okay, so when you feel better, we can have sex. But you love me right now. All right, that's great. Where's your remote control? You seen around here anywhere? I mean, generally speaking, we guys aren't even built to be able to talk as long as women can talk. When you do most of your conversation in a sitting position, guys can't sit comfortably as long as most women can. Women have the center of gravity in their bodies, in their hips. Guys have a lot of weight and muscle mass in their chest, upper shoulders, and back. That's why I watch guys in the night. You know, after about a half hour, guys try to get those shoulders down in a comfortable position. Look at this guy over here. Look how he slumped way down his chair over here. Guys will start leaning over this way. They'll start moving over that way. They'll start looking like they're on a ship trying to ride out of a storm. Women will sit here for an hour and a half, just make a couple adjustments throughout the evening of that center of gravity. Just a couple of, oh, there it is. I just half a bubble off. I'm okay now. That's why I'm convinced it was a man who invented the Barker Lounge and the easy chair. Not like women didn't have the ability to invent one, but it was a man who felt the necessity to invent one. I know what happened. Every night after dinner, this man's woman and him would go in the living room and she wanted to talk. And finally, one night she said, let's talk. He went, all right, dear, what do you want to talk about? Talk all night long now, no problem. Very comfortable. And I know if this man's woman's anything like my wife, what she said to him next was, I can't talk to you like this. You're not looking at me.